It's Professor Dave. Let's learn about Taylor and Maclaurin series.
He knows a lot about all kinds of stuff, Professor Dave explains.
In the previous tutorial, we talked about power series. These were series in the following form, c sub n times x to the n from 0 to infinity. We mentioned that the sum of a power series can be represented by a function, with terms involving each power of x all the way to infinity. But we may want to know something about all of these coefficients. Now that we understand differentiation, we are ready to expand our understanding of this kind of series. So let's talk about this now. Say we are looking at this power expansion, the series c sub n times the quantity x minus a raised to the n power. We can describe this with a function, but we may want to solve for these coefficients. It actually won't be as tricky as you think, given the difference x minus a in each of these terms. If we find f of a, all of these binomials become zero, and therefore all of these terms become equal to zero, except for the first coefficient here, c0. So f of a equals c0. With the first coefficient down, how do we get the next one? This is where differentiation comes into play. Let's say we take the derivative of this function. C0 will go away, since the derivative of any constant is zero. Then for the second term, x minus a will go away, leaving c1. To be clear, if we were to distribute before taking the derivative, we would get c1x minus c1a, and since c1a is just a number, that will go away, and c1x will become c1. For the other terms, we will use the chain rule. Starting with this one, the 2 comes down here, leaving an exponent of 1, and then we multiply by the derivative of what's inside, which will just be 1. So we are left with 2c2 times the quantity x minus a. The second part of the chain rule will always be 1 for the rest of these terms, so we can just do the part with the exponent. 3 comes down here, and the exponent becomes 2. 4 comes down here, and the exponent becomes 3. Now with this expression, which represents the first derivative of the function, if we plug in a, all of these terms will disappear, just like when we plugged a into the original function. The only thing left is c1. So f prime of a, or the derivative of f evaluated at a, equals c1. Let's go back to the expression for the first derivative and take the derivative again. C1 goes away, and this term becomes 2c2. Then we have 2 times 3, or 6c3, times the quantity x minus a. This next coefficient becomes 12, and so forth. Again, plugging in a for x will isolate the 2c2 term, so f double prime of a equals 2c2, or c2 equals f double prime of a over 2. By now, we might see a pattern. Taking the third derivative and plugging in a will give us f triple prime of a equals 6c3, or c3 equals f triple prime of a over 6, which can also be expressed as 3 factorial. Inputting a into the fourth derivative of f will give us 24c4, meaning that c4 equals the fourth derivative of f over 4 factorial. We can therefore set up an expression to find the nth coefficient of the series. C sub n equals the nth derivative of f evaluated at a divided by n factorial. This works for all the terms, even the first, if we understand that the zeroth derivative of a function is simply the function itself, and that 0 factorial equals 1. So to summarize, for the function given by the sum of c sub n times the quantity x minus a to the n power, where the absolute value of x minus a is less than the radius of convergence for the series, the coefficients of the function are given by this formula. If we then generate a new function of the same form, but substitute this formula in for c sub n, such that the terms in the series look like this, we have just generated the Taylor series of the function f at a, which can also be described as f about a, or f centered at a. So a Taylor series is a type of power series, but with the coefficients defined like so. Now that we understand what a Taylor series is, let's also define a special case. For the same type of function, but where a equals 0, this binomial becomes simply x to the n, and everywhere we were plugging in a, we simply plug in 0. So we get f of 0 plus f prime of 0 over 1 factorial times x, plus f double prime of 0 over 2 factorial times x squared, and so forth. This is a special kind of Taylor series called a Maclaurin series. This is a Taylor series where the expansion is about the point x equals 0. So we should definitely be aware of these definitions for a Taylor series and Maclaurin series, because we are going to apply these expansions to specific functions. Take, for example, e to the x. Let's find the Maclaurin series that represents the function f of x equals e to the x. That will be the nth derivative of e to the x evaluated at 0 over n factorial times x to the n. Well, what do we know about e to the x? The derivative of e to the x is e to the x, so no matter what derivative we are looking at, we just have e to the x. Also, we are plugging in 0 every time, and anything to the 0 power is 1. That means any derivative of this function evaluated at 0 will give us 1. So this entire term can just go away, leaving us with x to the n over n factorial. We can therefore quite easily begin writing out the series with x to the 0 over 0 factorial, or simply 1, plus x to the 1 over 1 factorial, plus x squared over 2 factorial, and so forth. This should look very familiar, as we have just derived a form for e to the x that we utilized earlier in this calculus series. That form was actually the Maclaurin series for the function. Let's make sure we can find the radius of convergence for this function. That will require the ratio test. We set that up and flip the denominator to get x to the n plus 1 over n plus 1 factorial times n factorial over x to the n. After some simplification, we can cancel some terms, and we get the absolute value of x over n plus 1, and as n approaches infinity, this goes to 0. 0 is less than 1, so the series converges for all values of x, and the radius of convergence is infinite. Taylor series have many applications, but for now, we will be satisfied with some simple definitions and come back to these concepts later. And with that, we have wrapped up our survey of calculus, so it's time to move on to some other topics. Before we leave, let's check comprehension. Thanks for watching, guys. Subscribe to my channel for more tutorials. Support me on Patreon so I can keep making content. And as always, feel free to email me, ProfessorDaveExplains@gmail.com.